Hey guys, in this video, we are going to set up environment for KMM in our macOS. So let's get started and please subscribe to the channel for more such content. So in this video, we are going to create a Hello World application using KMM in Android and iOS. So let's get started. For setting up the environment in your macOS, these are the 7 necessary tools that you will require in your macOS to set up the environment. If you have already installed Java and Android Studio in your macOS, then please skip this part. And if you don't have Java and Android Studio installed in your computer, then this is a video by Lisho Lim on YouTube where he step by step shows how you can install Java and how to set Java home in your macOS. And after installing Java and setting up the Java home, this is a video by Rotlin to install Android Studio smoothly and easily in your macOS. The video's link will be in the description, so don't worry about it. After installing Java and Android Studio and setup, you have to install Xcode in your macOS. To install Xcode, just go on the App Store and search for Xcode. Here, the first one you have to download. I have already downloaded Xcode in my macOS, so it's showing me the open option. And if it's first time for you to install Xcode, then here will be the option of download. Then just download the Xcode and just open it for first time. Then it will automatically run all the command lines for you by itself. After installing Xcode, then you will require Ruby in your macOS. To install Ruby, here's a video by Automation Step by Step where he describes step by step solution to install Ruby in your macOS smoothly. After installing Ruby on your macOS, just you have to install the Cocoa Pods. To install Cocoa Pods, you just have to open your terminal. And here in the terminal, you just have to enter these commands. These commands will be in the description, so don't worry about it. Here you have to first run the brew install cask Cocoa Pods. Just run this in your terminal and brew will automatically install the Cocoa Pods in your macOS. And if you wonder you don't have brew in your macOS, in the Ruby video, Automation Step by Step describes how you can install brew in your Mac. So don't worry about it. And I have already installed Cocoa Pods in my Mac, so I'm not going to run this query, but you have to install Cocoa Pods. After running this query, you just have to enter pod. Basically, to check that Cocoa Pod is installed successfully, you just have to run this command pod and it will show all the commands that you can execute with the pod. If you want to know more about pod, then you just have to do a Google search and there you will get the results. After installing Cocoa Pods, then you just have to run another command that is pod setup. After running this command, pod will download its packages and it will initialize the setup in your macOS. So after doing all this, you just have to install Kdoctor via brew in your terminal. Just a minute. Just run this command to install Kdoctor via brew in your Mac. After installing Kdoctor, you just have to enter the command Kdoctor. It's showing me the operating system, Java, Android Studio, Xcode, and Cocoa Pods are successfully installed and your system is ready for Kotlin Multiplatform Mobile development. Now folks, you are ready to use KMM in your macOS. So now we are going to close the terminal and we are going to open Android Studio and install all the plugins required for it. Here's only one plugin that you have to install in your Android Studio, that is Kotlin Multiplatform plugin. In the plugin section, in the market, just search for Kotlin and here you will see the Kotlin Multiplatform Mobile plugin. Just install this plugin in your Android Studio and just restart your Android Studio for once. After it will install the plugin in your Android Studio. After installing the plugin, here in the new projects, here you will see a Kotlin Multiplatform app and Kotlin Multiplatform library. From here, we are going to select the Kotlin Multiplatform App project and just click on Next. Here for the name, I'm giving my KMM app. And then just click on Next. And here you can see the name of your Android application, iOS application and shared module name. I'm just keeping this name default for this project. And here you can see iOS framework distribution. Here you have two options there about Cocoa Pods and a regular framework. For now, we are just going to click regular frameworks and just click on finish. Here we got an error about you have to use Java 11 or higher. So you just go in the Android Studio and settings. In the settings, just go to the build execution deployment, and in it, just go to the Gradle instruction, which is in the build tools, and just select the Java JDK from here. It should be more than Java 11, and be sure that you are using the same Java version that you have initialized in your Java home. And then just click on apply and OK. And now we have to reopen the file. So now here you just have to go in the project section, and in the later videos I will be explaining all the structure of KMM. So in the project section here you can see the Android app, iOS app and the shared section. So basically your Android code will be in this Android app, SRC, Java, main, and all. It is the same Android structure that you get in an Android Studio. Here in the main activity, as you can see, we have the Jetpack Compose code running the main activity in your application. And same will be for the iOS, and here will be the iOS structure. And also you will get the shared section here, in which you have Android main, common main, and iOS main. In the next video, I will be explaining what it means and what are the uses of this. So just for now, we are going to run the application in our Android Studio emulator, which is Pixel 6. Just click on the run button and your app will be compiled for Android. And if you want to run the app for iOS, then just you have to open this iOS app in your Xcode. That will be covered in the next video. So here you can see we have successfully created an KMM application for Android in our macOS. That's all for today's video. I appreciate your time and attention. If you found this video helpful, then please show your support by liking it and subscribing to my channel for future videos. See you in the next video.